Hi everyone, hope you all are doing very well, and this video is all about performance testing. So as we go for an interview, there are questions based on performance testing as well. So yeah, before we go for any tool, we just need to understand why we are doing performance testing, right? People should know the basic of it, and then maybe I have a next video on maybe part 2 which has Jira and LoadRunner questions. So many of the organization works on LoadRunner, so yes, we need to know about LoadRunner as well. So I have worked on both the tools, not Jira, that is JMeter, sorry. So JMeter and LoadRunner, we have a tool. So I've worked on both the tools. So, and I'll be sharing some of the questions on JMeter as well as in our LoadRunner questions. So I think the working patterns are the same, but we need to know why we are doing, and there are questions based on performance testing specifically. So what are types of parameters, and what are things we use in performance testing? What we should keep in mind for doing performance testing. So this video is all about that, and I just want to move to the next slide. And just as I told that, guys, please listen to me, because when I'm telling this, when I'm moving through the slide, I may got some points which is relevant to your interview, so that may help you. So yeah, move to the next slide. So what are the different types of performance testing? So the different types of performance testing are: first is load testing, endurance testing, volume testing, scalability testing, spike testing, and stress testing. So I think there are six types of testing which we mainly focus, and these are that. So, and then I'll move to the next one. I think this is a very basic question. I think everyone knows about it. So for 1 to 3 years of experience, you need to know about this one. Then what are the parameters considered for the performance testing? As I told you, that these are the questions which they are gonna ask, for example people will ask as an entry or exit criteria, right, for the testing. That's what are the parameters we consider in while doing testing, that's called those things, right? So in the performance testing also the same thing works. So here are parameters we will be considering: the memory usage, the best processor uses, bandwidth, memory pages, network output, queue length, response time, CPU interruption per second, committed memory, thread count, stop weights. I think these are the things we consider on performance testing based on different type of domain we work in. Okay. So what are the benefits of LoadRunner in testing tools? So this is a tool, right, when you use LoadRunner, so why you are using, what are the benefits of it? So because it's a very versatile tool, it gives you a test result. It is easy to integrate. If you want to integrate it, we can integrate it. It has a robust reports, and it has an enterprise package. So it has all the things, right? And it's a very easy tool also. You need to record, and there is a correlation ID which we need to match it. So I think we'll go low with the LoadRunner in my next tutorial. So I think this is the answer. These are the standard answers which you have to give it, and that's, the expectation of the interviewer. They'll be expecting from you guys. So I think these are the answers which you have to give it instead of telling the stories. So what are the different phases for automated performance testing? So when you automate that, so there are different factors, right? When you performance testing, where we do it in terms of automation, we find more bugs when we do the performance testing, right? And we usually integrated JMeter with many of Selenium, with many of the tools, right? So design and planning, okay, build, execution, and analyzing. So for the stable module, we have to check the performance, right? So these are the things that we have to design it, we have to build it, and in every build we have to execute it, and we have to analyze the bugs. So analyzing is the main thing, that how much time it will take to complete one flow, two flow, right? So one end-to-end flow. So that's, those are the scale, we'll be scaling it. So how do you identify the performance bottleneck situation? Okay, so this is a very important question. As you go for experience, and as you said, you have worked on performance testing only, so you have mainly, maybe for example in the testing you have worked on 50-45% maybe on performance testing, and the rest 30% on automation, and then 30% on manual. If you divide in that way, or maybe 20% on manual, the way you have divided it, so this is how it is, that performance bottlenecks are recognized by monitoring the app against the load and stress condition, right? To find the bottleneck, what is a bottleneck situation, right, in performance testing? The tester usually use load runner because it supports many different types of monitors like a runtime monitor, network delay monitor, web resource monitor, database server monitor, firewall monitor, ERP server resource monitor, and Java performance monitor. So these monitors in turn help to the tester to establish the condition which causes an increase in the response time of an application. So I think this is the answer which you have to know, and when you learn more about load runner, you'll be having all those details about runtime monitor, network delay monitor, web resource monitor, what is all about it. So I'm not going that, we're just gonna answer this question, and that is only the required for this question. So I think you should know the bottleneck situation as a performance tester. And now move to the next question. What is concurrent user load in performance testing? This is a very important question. So concurrent user load in performance testing can be defined as something when many users hit in any functionality or operation at the same time. So concurrent user, that is like when, like in the same, like for the click, so multiple user click, and in the many, for example, when you submit a something form, like let's say when the last date comes and in an online portal or something like that, like what online counseling and all, in the last day many people will hit the submit button at the same time, right? So that when the system will break because they have multiple user will do the same functionality at the same time. So what is a protocol and name of few protocols? So what are the protocols we use? It a protocol is defined as set of various rules, as we have already studied it on our college days, for the purpose of information and communication between two or more system, right? That's how we do it. We have to hit to the server, so we'll be using some protocols. So there are many protocols such as HTTP, HTTPS, FTP, web service, Citrix, HTTP, HTTPS, and web services. So I think those are the things through we communicate with the other thing, that right, other system. So that's all. Name a few common performance testing problems. So what are longer loading time, poor scalability, bottlenecking, poor response time. So these are the, these are the things which we need to know, because if you are a performance tester, you might know this. Okay. So name a few common performance bottleneck. Some popular common performance bottlenecks are CPU utilization, memory utilization, networking utilization, S limitation, disk usage. So I think when you know the performance testing and you have to monitor all those things, these are the bottlenecks of it. And when you're doing performance testing, you'll be optimal, like when you get the result, right? When you get the report, so you'll be monitoring all those stuffs. What are the parameter considered for the performance testing? The parameter I have already, I think this is the question we have repeated it. So okay, I have repeated it maybe because I have got the questions, and these are the questions which, yeah. Okay, so I like this one. Okay, difference between benchmark testing and baseline testing. So benchmark testing is a method deployed for comparing the performance of your system, right? Benchmark, right? We'll be having some benchmark, right? With that, it's a threshold, and we'll be comparing those things. So system framework performance against a set industry standard that is laid out already by some other organization, right? Whereas like benchmark testing is like that, like we have set in standard and we'll be testing our framework according to that, right? We have something that based on that we'll be comparing, and we'll do comparing the performance of a system. Whereas the baseline testing is a type of testing technique. I see the words are the common and the same words, like benchmark testing, baseline testing, as you're understanding, right? The words itself define everything. It's just that in terms of performance you need to know about it. So whereas the baseline testing is a type of testing technique where test and run a series of tests in order to get a hold of performance information. Okay, when any future changes is made in the given app, the data is then used as a reference point, right? We'll be baseline the information, right? So that's how we'll be doing. So what is performance tuning? It's a method or mechanism followed to improve the system performance. Highlight the need for opting off for performance. Why we need the performance testing? See, performance testing is generally required to validate the response time of an application for the intended number of users. When the number of virtual user, we can put the virtual user and we can test it. So when the number of user increases, we need to see the performance of the system. Okay, the response time, utmost load resisting capacity of an application, how much load it will take. The capability of an app under the test to handle the particular number of transactions, right? Make constancy of an application. Like for the banking, there are multiple transactions happen at the same time. So that's when we need performance. and the consistency of an application under the usual and unexpected usual. So what happens is sometimes the load is so much, but sometimes there's no none of the user were there in the ATM, right? So that's what happens. So it should balance. It cannot use all the memory when when no one is using it. So that's how we have to balance it, making sure that the user have an appropriate response time on production. Okay. So what is throughput? This is very important. What is throughput in performance testing? So throughput in performance testing is either the quantity of data sent by the server in response to the client request in a particular given period of time, or it is a specific number of units of work that can be handled in per unit of time. So per unit of time, its throughput is like how much we will be like in the given period of time, how much data will server will respond with the data, right? So and throughput is calculated in terms of requests received per second. This line is very important. Throughput is calculated in terms of requests received per second, calls per day, reports per year, etc. In the majority of cases, the throughput is permeated in bits per second. Okay. And what is profiling in performance testing? So profiling is a procedure of pinpointing a bottleneck performance at miniature level. Okay. So profiling, we'll be doing profiling, right? So this is done by presentation team for manufacturing, which is mainly includes developers or performance tester. You can profile in any application layer which is getting testing. If you want to do the application profiling, you may require utilizing tools for performance profiling of application server. So these are the very important questions. I think throughput and the profiling also is an important question. So I think I have covered in this is very short video, I think, as compared to the insurance domain and all those questions what we have. So I've put in all the performance questions, performance testing question, and so in the next video we'll be having load runner and JMeter questions, and I think these are the questions which I've put in the interview. All are very important questions, and if you don't like the answer also, it's fine, you can have your own answer. That's take out the questions, that is important. If you want the slide, I can give it to you. Just want you know the drill, what you have to do. You have to put your mail ID below, and yes, I'm gonna share some people have mentioned their mail ID. I'm gonna share that, and just don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. And share it with your friends. Thank you so much, guys. Bye.